So I'm filming this on Sunday night. Oh no, my hair tie's really stuck. I'm filming this on Sunday night. I probably won't post it till Monday. And here we go. I also have my hairbrush. At least a year ago, maybe a year and a half ago, and I love it. If you can manage it, I recommend it, but I go to bed pretty early, so I just go to bed when I'm tired, and I wake up when I wake up. Now the dog, I do have two dogs, and one of them is not a morning dog, but the other one is. And so if I don't get up, she will wake me up. And today she woke me up at 8. So I did sleep in today. Yeah, but that is getting ahead of myself. So Friday, I had to use an alarm to make sure I got up on time. So I got up at 6 so that I could take the dogs to the kennel. Especially the little dog. I think she likes the kennel more than she likes it here. There are more friends there. So, the bigger dog, he's more of a homebody. He really just wants to be wherever I am. So sometimes he interrupts videos because he wants to be like right here. But he likes the kennel. They go to daycare there about once a week, so he's used to it. So I took the dogs to the kennel, and then I got on a plane and I flew. Airport, and I don't know why, because it's not a hub for any airline that I know of, but the airport is spacious and really clean, and it has like a lot of food options and shopping options, although I've never shopped at an airport. So has a canal running through the center, and it's pretty, and there were ducks and geese, and I walked past a historic church. It was interesting. It was run down, and it looked like it was no longer used, which was too bad, because I think it's an actual, like, historical. I also saw the biggest Catholic church I've ever seen in the U.S. It was just like big, just wide. I mean, it was like a whole block, like bigger than a normal block. All the students at Indiana University. experience for me. I've been to this conference before, but never alone. So last time my advisor came with, but this time it was just me. And I was a little nervous. I don't think that I'm great at small talk. To Indiana Friday morning, and I came back. just Chinese. There's also Korean and I think Japanese hot pot that probably have different flavors and spices, but I'm more familiar with Chinese hot pot. And so there's a central pot. Normally, there are individual places, like places where you have an individual pot, but traditionally, hot pot is choose your broth, so you can go spicy or not spicy or ting, like clear broth. There are different options. A common kind is to do five different kinds of broth. We only did two. So we did a spicy side and a ting, yeah, like a clear side. And you order lots of meat and vegetables and noodles, and no, that's about it. I guess mushrooms if you want. And then you throw them in the pot, and so the meat is cut really, really thin, like, and in a roll, and you toss it in the pot, and it cooks really fast if the pot is boiling, and then you can eat it. You also often have like a dipping sauce, and so you take your meat or your vegetable, your baicai, like cabbage. Hello, camera. Or tofu, and you dip it in your dipping sauce. And so we had a peanut dipping sauce. Another traditional one is like a sesame dipping sauce. I love sesame. All you can eat. So normally they charge by the dish, so you buy like a dish of meat, a dish of cabbage, a dish of tofu, and each one of those costs some amount of money. But this was just all you can eat, so everyone paid the same price. But it was good. We got sweet potato. Ready?